It looks like David Pakman is under some hot water once again with his fans. This is not something that rarely happens. This seems to happen, you know, pretty regularly, I would say. Now, he just posted a video titled "Caller Attacks Because David Hasn't Endorsed Bernie." And if you look at the like and dislike ratio right now, it's 512 likes to 394 dislikes. And the comments are all going after him. But we're going to look at the comments later on. We're going to go through the video first. Now, David Oakman is talking to a guy by the name of Dante, who I believe has a news channel called Unapologetic. And he calls in to ask why he hasn't endorsed Bernard Sanders yet. Now, I did a video talking about how David says he's undecided between Warren and Bernie. He's also on record as saying that Bernie is marginally more progressive. Bernie is marginally more progressive than Bernie Sanders. And so he's refused to endorse. All right. And so he's going to really question him. Now, the thing is, this video is 9 minutes long and I can't show you the whole thing. So we're going to 2x the speed here. So let's go ahead.
Let's go next to, let's go to Dante from Florida, who often has interesting takes. We haven't heard from him for a while. Dante is a Bernie supporter who at one point flirted with supporting Tulsi, but now he is strongly Bernie, right, Dante? I think this time I got it right.
No. That Tulsi Gabbard thing, he says Tulsi Gabbard. I know he's trying to troll, but for some reason, the Tulsi Gabbard one is just kind of cringe. I don't know about you.
I was never really supporting Tulsi Gabbard. I just always, like, she was doing with the candidacy and the foreign policy issue that she brought up, so always try to give her some attention when I get a chance.
All right, but you were never considering supporting her. You were always Bernie then.
Yeah, it was always Bernie.
Gotcha. Okay, what's going on, Dante? Tell me.
So, that was actually something I wanted to ask you about. Because I wanted you to clarify your position about not endorsing a candidate in the primary, because it doesn't really make sense to me. So, if you could explain that?
What do you want me to explain?
Your reasoning for why you don't want to support a candidate or endorse a candidate, or what you think it might lead to? Because I think from the explanation, you said you don't want to add to the circular firing squad on the left or something like that by supporting one candidate over the other.
Yeah, listen, I mean, I'm nobody. I'm just a guy who's analyzing politics. Everybody who watches my show, I think, understands my positions. You know, I've seen that there has been an attempt lately to smear me as saying that Bernie...
No. You're not just a guy who's analyzing politics. You're a guy with a politics show who covers the news with almost 800,000 subscribers. You're not just a guy who just analyzes and, you know, no watches you, or you don't have any significance or anything like that. No. That's not true whatsoever. Don't even try to claim that.
And Warren are the same. It's like, you know, I've been clear, they're not the same. Bernie comes from a far more left place than Elizabeth Warren.
Certainly has not been very clear on this, as evidenced by his quote saying that Bernie is marginally more progressive than Warren, and he always bunches up Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders together. So, you know, he certainly has not made it clear of that at all. That's completely false.
Their policies today are very similar, but, you know, for example, Elizabeth Warren voted in favor of scaling up funding for the military, something that I'm against. Bernie voted against it. Like, they're not the same. I've been abundantly clear. At this point, I just, like, what
no,
do we gain?
You have not been abundantly clear, not at all.
By me coming out and saying I am endorsing this person over that person, when the truth is I'm going to vote for whoever is the eventual Democratic nominee. I'm not going to hide who I vote for in the primary. I mean, I'm covering the issues and the candidates. I just don't see what advantage there is to me now coming out and saying I'm all about this candidate over that candidate. I mean, listen, like, it's no secret. I made it clear Bernie is to the left of Elizabeth Warren, and I would vote for either of them, and I think it's imperative that we remove Donald Trump. Like, what would an endorsement do? Would it make a difference to you if I endorse one person or another? Like,
so to me, it makes a difference as to who you endorse, because it indicates to me, you know, where you really lie politically and how progressive you are. And so if you're somebody who's going to endorse Elizabeth Warren over Bernie Sanders, the truth is you're not a, like, legit progressive, okay? If you have this idea in your head that Elizabeth Warren is more progressive than Bernie Sanders and you would vote for her over him, then it tells me that you're not as progressive as you claim. That's what it says. And so the reason why I want him to do this is because it's an indication to me that he's, you know, serious about actual change, and that he's also not a milquetoast centrist. That's what it tells me. And so it's a serious test to really see whether or not you're actually a progressive. And I want you to sit back and think about this for a minute. I'm going to pose you a question, okay? Think of any other progressive YouTube figure who is struggling between Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders in the YouTube sphere, okay? You can't think of anybody. Cenk Uygur came out and endorsed Bernie Sanders, and he's the worst on that because he was... You know, he kept giving Elizabeth Warren a bunch of leeway and all this nonsense, which was ridiculous, but he endorsed Bernie Sanders, okay? He endorsed Bernie Sanders. Anna Kasparian endorsed Bernie Sanders. David Pakman doesn't. Kyle is very clear that Bernie Sanders is the candidate. I just talked to Farron Cousins recently. He's like, yeah, dude, it's very obvious that Bernie Sanders is the most progressive. It's not even close. So people, like, how does David Pakman find himself in these unique dilemmas where he's the only person who's having these problems? How does he get into these conundrums? No one else is having this problem. Cenk was having this problem, but now it's gone because he fucking endorsed Bernie Sanders. So is it really that hard? Like, he's acting as if we're asking this guy to, single-handedly beat the 2017 Golden State Warriors or something like that. Like, dude, this is literally the easiest thing in the world, and it's to endorse a candidate who you genuinely support for President of the United States. And if you want to come out and endorse Elizabeth Warren, I would at least respect you for coming out and doing that. But he's too much of a weasel and a coward to even do that.
Supporting Bernie, you know that, that's fine. You know
what? It's not really the endorsement part. It's more that you have a show, and I think it's important to be crystal clear about it and leave no room for ambiguities in the audience that Bernie Sanders is clearly better. He's just a better candidate. It's not that. He's good on some issues, and he's better than Elizabeth Warren on some issues, and she's pretty good on other issues. Like, it's not even close. Bernie Sanders.
Well, but Dante, you understand that that's your opinion, right?
But you host a program and you're a social democrat, and if you're a social democrat, it's not really close. You say that Bernie Sanders is more left.
Yes.
So by your estimation, I mean he's better. Because you're a social democrat, so even the social democratic ideology of social democratic economic reform and
so this is where it gets odd, and you know, David Pakman's trying to figure out how to be a weasel here, as he usually is. So he says, that's your opinion. Are you saying that's not your opinion, that Bernie Sanders is better? Like, are you saying that Bernie Sanders... I don't know if he's saying that Bernie is more left is his opinion, or if it's that Bernie Sanders is better because he's left, or if it's just that Bernie Sanders is left is his opinion. And if that's his opinion, and you're saying, well, that's your opinion, are you implying that it's not your opinion? If so, be open about it and tell us if you think Warren is better than Bernie.
And progressive tax system is the best way to run the country, and Bernie Sanders is more aligned with you on those issues, so he's the best candidate. So... I guess the point I'm trying to make is, it's not that I think you should endorse him because of a boost that I think it would give to Bernie Sanders. I think it's just important to be clear that if you're someone who wants real, like, structural change, fundamental change in U.S. politics, revolutionary, yep. Like a political revolution, it's not like you can just choose either one and it'll be basically the same or be close to the same. There's a very big difference.
But Dante, let me ask you a question. This is a thought experiment, okay? So don't go crazy. I don't want people in the audience to go crazy.
We got the thought experiments coming in. This is interesting. It's an interesting strategy when you can't. I don't know. To me, whenever you have to like backdrop to thought experiments. To me, it seems like you're trying to be kind of slimy is what it seems like to me.
Let's imagine we all agree without placing a value judgment on anything. We agree Bernie is to the left of Warren. It sounds like you and I are on the same page about that, right? You said it and I'm saying it now.
Yeah, it's an objective fact.
Okay. Warren, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Imagine that we became convinced that even though Bernie is further to the left of Warren, this is hypothetical, that Warren's policy is more likely to become a reality for whatever reason, right? This is hypothetical. Would it then still be just as clear to you that we are better off by putting in someone who is further to the left but less likely to accomplish things? This is just a hypothetical. This is just me saying, just because we identify who's further left, that's not all there is to it. Would you agree that there's some element there that we would have to consider about that?
So this is interesting. So he says, whoa, bro, this is just a hypothetical. Don't take this seriously, okay? This is just a hypothetical. This is not my opinion. I repeat, this is not my opinion. This is a hypothetical. To me, it sounds like he's taking that into account, into his decision-making as to who is the better candidate, but he's too afraid and too scared to admit that. So to me, it comes across as David Pakman is a believer that, Elizabeth Warren will be able to get more of her stuff passed through Congress than Bernie Sanders. And that's why I'm kind of teeter-tottering between the two and low-key on the DL. I think I support Warren and that's who I'm going to vote for, but I don't want to say it right now. that's what it seems like to me, because if it's a hypothetical, right, then why are you not just telling us what your opinion on that is? That's what I'm confused about. Why offer us the hypothetical? Why not tell us whether or not that is your opinion? Like, David, is your opinion that Elizabeth Warren is better because more of her stuff could get passed? That's my question to be asked there. It just seems weird that you would you sort of bring that up in that way.
In the hypothetical, but here in the real world, in the 2020 primary, and we can look at their record, we can look at what they plan on doing, and okay. Bernie Sanders, even though his policies could some would seem more radical, he has a better chance of passing it because he has an actual plan of doing it. Elizabeth Warren, she has not really explained how she wants to get any of these things done because she's not in favor of primary and corporate Democrats like Bernie Sanders is. She's not going to bust up the establishment like Bernie Sanders is. She's not gonna do rallies in Joe Manchin's state when he votes against Medicare for All like Bernie Sanders said he would.
Right.
But Bernie Sanders is bringing grassroots pressure. So his policies are better and he has a better chance of passing it. He has
okay, but again, Dante, that's you seem to be mistaking. So I'm trying to have a conversation with you about what you first brought up, which is just about, you know, the idea of whether I should or shouldn't be endorsing someone. But now you're just making it, you're saying, well, your opinion is A, B, and C about Bernie, but I'm trying to have a different conversation with you. You know what I mean? I think we're talking past each other.
No, it's not that I'm crystal clear. Your opinion. You just brought up the fact that it might not be crystal clear that Bernie Sanders is the best because she might be able to get her.
It's not about best.
Pass, but I'm saying.
All right, listen, well, Dante, I think the takeaway, I got a lot of people holding, so I'm going to let you go. But the takeaway is you think that morally I should be making an endorsement on the program.
No, it's not morally. I think that you should just be clear with the audience and make sure that there's no room for interpretation. Elizabeth Warren, she's not going to challenge the political establishment. The
I believe that I've been clear with that. So if you go back, Dante, to my first, see, this is the problem I have, that I am being clear, but there's a lot of propaganda misstating my position. So for example, if you go back to the first clip I did about, it's called something like, there are serious differences between Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders. The primary thing that I state is that although they've come close on policy in 2019, now 2020, Bernie's approach is of totally that the system is broken and you need to change the system at its core. Whereas Elizabeth Warren comes from the camp of fixing the things about the system that are broken. In my first clip pointing out the differences between the two of them, I did exactly what you're pointing out I haven't done.
So we're supposed to look at his first video on it and not all of his comments that he has made very, very recently. Those comments being that Bernie is only marginally more progressive than Elizabeth Warren is, and that he always bunches them up together and that he says that he is undecided between the two.
Well, you just said it, Dante.
That you should be clear, and because it's not just me. Other people who watch your show come with the same takeaway. That
all right, well, listen to other people. All right, Dante, point taken. Let's make it about you. I appreciate what you're saying, and don't worry, you're going to know who I vote for. That I promise you.
Okay, thank you.
All right, Dante, thank you very much. Let's take a quick break. If you are holding, don't.
So listen, there's no need for all this. This is my biggest issue, and this is why I say David Pakman is a fucking weasel. Okay, and I don't even see how you could debate against that, honestly, at this point. Seriously, dude, this guy just spent over 9 minutes trying to weasel his way and slime me through not giving an answer as to who he supports. That's what he just did. And again, let me repeat to you folks, who else has this problem? No one has this problem. It's just David Pakman. He's the only one. And somehow he's having so much trouble with telling us who the fuck it is that he's endorsing, okay? Now, I think he's a Warren supporter. I think on the DL, I think he likes Warren. And I think that he's really a Warren fan, and I think that's probably who he's going to end up voting for. And it's obvious with that hypothetical that he gave, that's totally not his position, which it obviously is. I think he's a Warren fan, honestly. He's in Massachusetts. Maybe he has a soft spot for Elizabeth Warren. I think that's what he is. I think he's a Warren fan, honestly. He just doesn't want to admit it. Now, another thing could be maybe he's not announcing his support for Bernie Sanders because his channel, uniquely from all the other progressive channels, is that a lot of these subscribers that he has, now he has almost 800,000, a lot of these subscribers that he has, they're resistance wine moms, like they're resistance people who are the Orange Man Bad, you know, group of people, you know, who come on his videos where he does Trump neurologically malfunctions or Trump farted during a speech, part 10 of 20 episode documentary. Like that type of stuff, and they'll come on his videos and subscribe to him. So I think he also doesn't want to piss off a lot of his audience with that. And so I think there are a couple of things going on here, but David Pakman is a pretty massive weasel. He likes to slide through a bunch of things without answering questions. And this has really become more and more apparent to me as time has gone on. Now, if you read these comments, says Dante is right. David is unclear about which candidate he prefers. Repeating factual statements about who is further left comes off as evasive. Instead of endorsement, you can tell us who you vote for before you set up primaries. That sure as hell isn't an attack. So some people took... There are people who are taking problem with his title, which is Caller Attacks David because he hasn't endorsed Bernie, because they're saying, dude, this guy respectfully discussed this issue with you. How is this attack? Like, and it is kind of... It is kind of a sort of random sort of thing. Like, it's not even close to being an attack. So it's not even an exaggeration. It's not an exaggeration. It is a straight-up lie, okay? And people are taking issue with this. And also, people are taking issue with this stuff for a good reason because, you know, when he did the whole Medicare for All isn't happening, people were like, dude, you used a clickbait title, and then you're like, wow, people are just reading the title. Well, yeah, why are you using clickbait titles, you know what I'm saying, if they don't represent the video? And so a bunch of people are just talking about the whole attack thing and how it was clickbait. This one says, hi, we're trying to decide which member of the Justice League is best. We're all going to vote. I think it's Batman. Who do you support? Listen, I'm just a guy who does comic analysis. It doesn't matter who I support. I will end up choosing the better of the two final options at the end anyway. So I'll tell you who I voted for after the vote. I've been very clear on the differences between Batman and Superman. Austin says, yeah, I'll side with the caller. David has to realize he has a right to keep their privacy. He's somewhat of a public figure. And so there are a bunch of people. Still clear when you stand firm and send a clear message. We are done compromising. Elizabeth Warren will immediately start with a compromise and work down. That is very true. And so this is what we're looking at here, man. This is what we're looking at here. I mean, he's really just being slimy, dude. Super, super slimy. I think it's a pretty dumb take on David's part, saying that the assertion that Bernie's a better candidate is just the caller's opinion is just what? Is it not your opinion? That's the thing. It's like, if you're going to say that that's his opinion, are you implying that it's not your opinion? That's my question. And that's why I think he's a weasel and he's slimy. That's what it seems like to me, man, because if you're going to give, like, if you support Warren, right? Let's say David Oakman is a big Warren guy, right? Fine, come out and endorse Warren then. But don't, like, weasel your way out of it because you're scared of the response. That's so weak and so lame. So unbelievably lame. And so it doesn't look like we're going to get an actual answer from David anytime soon.